Peace talks between Israel and the Palestinians are set to go ahead in Washington after the Israeli cabinet approved the release of 104 Palestinian prisoners. The Palestinians had made the prisoner release a condition of restarting negotiations, which broke down in 2010. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said that it was a difficult moment, but tough decisions had to be made for the good of the country. Netanyahu's ministers were divided over the issue.
Everybody feels bad about the idea of releasing the prisoners because this is a bunch of really hideous people with a terrible history, but we have to do what we have to do in order to make the peace process progress.
I think that Israel is not allowed to free those terrorists that killed the Jewish. And I think that we can negotiate with the Palestinians without those horrible things.
The prisoner release has provoked strong responses among the Israeli public, with a protest against the move held in Jerusalem. The head of One Terror Victims Association blasted U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry for his role in bringing Israel and the Palestinians back to the negotiating table.
It's a shame to the American nation that Kerry is making his career on the back of the families who lost a loved one. It's a shame for the American nation that the negotiation with the Palestinians and the Islamic organization are starting by paying, releasing terrorists first.
The Palestinian prisoners will be released in four stages over the next several months as peace talks continue. Netanyahu has also said that any potential peace deal with the Palestinians will be put to a referendum.